Time today for our monthly For Our Veterans segment, which we so enjoy having here. And Shane Faulkner here with the Oklahoma Department of Veteran Affairs. Good to have you here. Along with Paul Merchant, a Vietnam vet. Mm-hmm. First of all, I want to thank you both for your service and your families as well, because when one person serves, the whole family serves.
It's my honor. Thank you.
And that's the truth. Absolutely. You guys have had some special events coming up here recently, or held some recently, concerning actually those that served in Vietnam. Tell me about it, Shane.
Well, this was actually a movement by the Department of Defense. This actually started a couple of years ago in coordination with the 50th anniversary of the start of the Vietnam War. As a lot of people know, it's a pretty dark part of our history in America, our troops coming home from that.
Yes.
A lot of guys really didn't get the chance to get the ticker tape parades that a lot of veterans get nowadays.
That's right.
A lot of guys came home and threw their uniforms right into the closet to never be talked about again.
Right.
So the Department of Defense started this, and it's basically given Vietnam veterans that welcome home that they never got.
I think that's great.
And we run our 7 long-term care facilities here in the state, and we had a ceremony at each one to recognize the Vietnam veterans that not only lived there, Kent,
right,
but we also invited Vietnam veterans that live out in the community.
That's cool.
To come in, and we got plenty in, and I can show you some pictures of
Let's
the Clinton ceremony. And
yeah.
The Clinton ceremony, those are veterans from out in the public that heard about it, and they came in, and they want to be part of this, and we couldn't be more happy to have them. These are pictures from Clinton. I think I also got, and you could just see the turnout there. We're standing room
Gosh,
only.
It is a lot of folks there. That's great.
And the outpouring that these Vietnam veterans get is, it's well-deserved, and it is long overdue. And that is the pin that we present them with, each Vietnam veteran that we come in contact with. We present them with that pin, and we thank them for their service.
Paul, I saw a bumper sticker back during the first Gulf War that said, "I ain't no desert hero, I'm a Vietnam vet." And it really struck a chord with me when I saw that bumper sticker, and I thought, it is different. Tell me what it means to you for this recognition to be happening now.
Well, I have kind of a unique perspective because I was also in Iraq.
Mm-hmm.
So I got both homecomings. In my return from Vietnam, on my aviation tour, we came into SeaTac in Seattle, Tacoma. We were put on a bus, painted black windows, and we were taken to a center. We were asked if we had civilian clothes to change in civilian clothes. And then we moved to the commercial side of the airport in small groups so that we could avoid the protesters. That's 1970. We fast forward to when I come back from Iraq in 2006, and we get on a bus when we get off the airplane, and they have these fire engines shooting red, white, and blue water over us.
So cool.
And so it was a little embarrassing, actually, because I'm sitting there going, is this really how it is supposed to be?
Right.
And do these guys on the bus appreciate how it's supposed to be?
Right, exactly.
So that's kind of the contrast.
Well, I'm really glad you guys are holding this program, and somebody out there is watching right now and may be interested in if you served, they'd like to have one of those pins, and they contact you.
They should contact us, Ken. We are also out in the community, and anytime we run into a Vietnam veteran, we present them with that pin, our VSRs that go and help these guys with their planes. And here's something that I really want to drive home with this, Kent, is that we have here in the state of Oklahoma about 110,000 veterans that served in Vietnam.
Right.
Only 40% of that population are receiving benefits from the VA.
Oh, wow.
And a lot of that has to do with the fact that these guys, once they came home, my father being one of them,
right,
they wanted nothing to do with the military or the VA because of the way they were treated when they got home. And a lot of guys over the years, they were maybe turned down for a claim. The thing that they have to remember is that so many things have changed over the years that you can now file a claim for.
Good.
So only 40% of Vietnam veterans receiving benefits. That's not a good number.
No, you guys call and get that handled.
That's exactly
for sure.
Right.
I know
right.
It was emotional when you gave that
it
to your dad.
It absolutely was. Dad never talked about his service, and I never knew why until getting older later on and seeing how these guys were treated when they got home, and it made sense.
Right.
And I might add that at every one of the events that I go to, I'm always surprised at the number of people that still come forward. You would kind of assume that we had it covered.
Right.
Now, we did a large program in 2010, so this commemorative has been going on for a while.
Right.
And yet, when I go to an event that ODVA puts on, there are still lots of veterans that haven't been welcome.
Right, exactly. All right, guys, thank you for being here
thank you,
sir. I'm really glad you're doing that
Appreciate
program.
It.
Just check out the Oklahoma Department of Veteran Affairs website. We have a link at KFR.com, and get the benefits that you earned.
You're
Keep
entitled.
It here.